So this numerical is once again regarding the uniform circular motion. An object is moving or a vehicle is moving in a uniform circular motion around the ball, okay, of diameter 28 meters, and it is taking around 22 seconds to finish the full circle. So you need to find the uniform circular motion. We studied that last time, that speed of an object is given by 2 pi r upon time taken if it is in uniform circular motion. Correct? But first of all, we need to find the radius because we have been given the diameter. Okay, so don't get confused. Observe the question carefully every single time. So radius is given as diameter by 2. Simple. 28 by 2 will give you 14 meters. So now that you have the radius, you have the time as well. You just need to solve by applying the formula. So S is equal to 2 into 22 upon 7 into radius is 14 meters. And you divide it by the time given, that is 22 seconds. Okay? Now this 7 goes into the denominator, or you can solve it as it is 7 into 14. So what you can do, S is equal to 2 into 22 into 2 upon 22. 22 gets cancelled, so the remaining is 2 into 2 as 4 meters per second. So the speed of the object moving in uniform circular motion is 4 meters per second. I hope that is clear to you, students. Okay, students, so this example is exactly what I was telling you in the previous one. Okay? It states that find the time taken by a car to achieve the velocity of 54 kilometers per hour in 225 meters. So over here you need to find the time taken, but you are not provided with the acceleration. So once again, first thing that you have to do is find the acceleration. And how will you do that? By applying the second equation or the third equation. But in this case, you are supposed to find the time. So let's say that you can find the acceleration with the help of three equations. You have these three equations, and in all these three equations you have acceleration, but you are required to find the time as well. So you cannot use the first or the second equation, you will have to use the third equation in order to find the acceleration first. And after finding the acceleration, you can apply this formula to find the time, because you have the final velocity as well. So first thing you need to do is state all the values. U is 0 meters per second. Final velocity V is 54 kilometers per hour, converting it in meters per second. Okay. Second, as the conversion of the velocity. Okay? After this step, all you need to do is apply the distance and the final velocity in the third equation. So we apply the equation, that is 2as is equal to v square minus u square, that is 15 square minus u square. Acceleration you need to find. Distance has been given as how much? 225 meters. So you apply the value of S, that is displacement of distance. 50 square is 225 minus 0. So it is going to remain 0. So simple. To find find an acceleration, what you have to do? Cross multiply everything. So what you get is 25 upon 2 into 25. Because both of these are in numerator, when they go on the other side, they will be denominator. Cross multiplication. 225 to 25 can cancel. What you get is 1 by 2 meters per second square. So you now have the acceleration. Okay? Now you can substitute these values in the first equation of motion. That is, V is equal to U plus AT. Final velocity is 15, like we calculated, 15. Initial velocity is 0. Acceleration is 1 by 2 in time you need to find. Now anything plus 0 is going to remain the number itself. So you have 15 is equal to half into t. Cross multiplication of 2, 15 into 2 becomes t. Therefore, t is equal to 30 seconds. This is how you are supposed to apply this to the equations. You can find any one of the values by using a proper equation of motion. Okay?